and lack of mind, lack of or mind roads and limited means of transportation. Despite those challenges, people started rebuilding their lives because there's finally peace. And residual insecurity was, of course, in Southern Sudan too. This is the life of a young boy in one village in Southern Sudan with his kettles. A woman with her three children after the peace, working freely. This is our supermarket. Children in school. And finally, water was coming, clean water. And in that peace agreement, there's one provision. The point 1-3 on page 8 of the Machakos Protocol. This is what it says. The people of South Sudan have the right to self-determination inter alia through a referendum to determine their future. So that clause is one of the keys of the whole peace agreement. Without that clause, the peace agreement was never going to be signed. And not only that, the time area of Abyei, simultaneously says, with the referendum for Southern Sudan, the residents of Abyei will cast a separate ballot for proposition voted on in the separate ballot, which will present the resident of Abyei with the following choices, irrespective of the result of Southern Sudan referendum. That Abyei retain its special administrative status in the north, or the Abyei be part of Bahrangazal. Bahrangazal is one of the states in Southern Sudan. So Abyei area, these are people mainly from Southern Sudan, they are thinkers from Southern Sudan. But that specific area was transferred to the north for administrative purposes only, long time ago. So for only administrative purposes, that area was administered in the north. But there are Southern Sudanese in their thinking. And during the peace agreement, the people of Abyei said, we are also thinkers, we are from the south. Our area was administered in the north, not through our way. But this time we want to be able also to go with our African brethren in the south. So that's why that provision was taken. So this is, if with this referendum, the map of Southern Sudan is right there. So the people of South Sudan have the right to vote. So that is why this referendum that is starting right now, that is what it will result. And it is widely believed that Southern Sudan will be the 193rd country, the newest country of the world. I know that there's going to be challenges, but that's why we are here to pray. So this will be the newest country of Southern Sudan after this referendum. So we are here to pray, and this prayer, by let them help neighbor. It says it's a serenity prayer. God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. So this is a short presentation. I know that there's a lot of history, there's a lot of information, but this is just a short presentation that I want to give to those who do not know what has been happening in Sudan. I know that many people are emotional. I know that a lot of people died. And if people are crying, it's not because of anything, but because 2 million people died. 2 million people died. For what? We are here to pray. We did not get a chance to go and vote, but we are voting here tonight, right now, through our prayers. We will vote for our prayers, and I hope that the results of the CPA, I mean the referendum, will be respected, and then let just people be good neighbors. It's been a long time. If people cannot be together, there's no need to put them together so that they can kill each other. It's better to be good neighbors and people realize how important human life is. Thank you very much for this opportunity. With this,